Sorry, I don't even have time to announce anything. It's coming. Okay, let's go for light language. Pleiadian Council of Seven. That's the light language today. You to find peace within yourself. I have so many people now, I can feel, I can see it. The room is full. I'm trying to stop the light language, but it's automatic. Sorry for that. Adama is present here. Adama is the highest priest, is a Lemurian being. Lemurians being today are living under the earth. We have been at war, is Adama speaking. We have been at war for so long that we lost the Lemuria. We lost our continent, but we learned from our mistake. We want you to evolve. This is why we are always there to support you. I have a comment there. Commander also from the Pleiadians. Okonia, I will tell you later on because I really have to channel the light language. This light language is for you to find peace. We want you, they all speak at the same time. We want you to open your container, which is your physical body. Open to receive and set your intention. If you still have any form of resentment, if you feel some repressed anger, frustration, this light language is for you. That is the reason why today we wanted her to channel only light language to find peace within yourself. Some of you are here with huge level of expectation. We want you to drop expectation. Expectation leads to disappointment. This is Adama speaking. We want you to find peace. By having too many expectations, you can't find peace. This is a difficult exercise that you have to do on a daily basis. Drop expectation. You have too many. Drop the attachment to things. This is also linked to disappointment. You are attached to your car. You are attached to your house. But this is not the point of life. You can have everything, but don't be attached to it. Drop the attachment. Ashtar Commander wants to answer to that question. His name is Ashtar, and he says, please say your question. We are ready.
Questions from Melissa. How can I welcome more financial abundance and have financial flow in my life?
This is a common situation for many of you in the world, in general, on this planet. Money is an energy, but when you look at money, it's just a paper. It's nothing else than a paper. But you gave it too much importance and you attached yourself. Do not attach yourself, detach yourself from money. I'm speaking now about the money itself. That you can understand that the money, it's a paper and it's an energy. From the moment you understand that money is an energy and that money gives you power, money gives you freedom. When I say this, it means money gives you freedom. Money gives you power. Find the power within you. Find the freedom within you. Open your heart to receive love. Release any form of self-hatred, any form of grudge, resentment, any form of anger, which is a huge blockage to receive the flow of abundance. Yes, they have a lot of work for many of you. And yes, you don't know where to start. Let me go with you step by step. It will give you a bit more clarity on what you have to do. Understand first that feeling abundant, it's not having a Ferrari. It's not having a beautiful house near to the beach. Abundance can be felt by a monk who has nothing. And that's what they feel. They learn how to use their own power and to go inside, to feel their own abundance. They can get money tomorrow if they want. They made different choice. This is an example I'm giving to you to tell you that you have to claim your power back. And yes, I know the next question is how to do it. This is a very important subject for everyone. Money. Abundance. Number one, receive is important, but most of you are not able to receive because they have blockage in their heart. From the moment you understand that you need to release all the blockage in your heart to receive, that's step number one. And go to do the work. Release everything you have, like grudge resolve. Release any attachment. Be in the now. When we say be in the now, it means most of you are living either in the past or in the future. You run after something that doesn't exist for most of you. Learn to live here now in the present, even if it's only for 2 minutes. Most of you are not capable to do that. And this is a very important lesson. Because when it comes to manifest more flow of abundance in your life, more money, you have to be here and now. You don't manifest in the past or in the future. You manifest it now. Now, work on bringing your power back. Most of you feel not worthy. Most of you feel I don't deserve. How do you want to attract more abundance, flow in your life, and more money if you still feel I'm not worthy, I'm not good enough, and I don't deserve? we give you a general picture now, because we speak for most of you. They have always exception. Then how to get more flow of abundance, get more money, look at the money as an energy. When you will be able to see money as an energy, you will understand that it's not something you need to catch. It's something you need to allow to come to you, and to allow this energy of money to come to you, you must open your heart. You must feel secure, powerful, worthy, that you feel you deserve and you are good enough to receive. Nobody else is better than you. Because most of the time you compare yourself with others. This is an attribute that you have a lot here on this planet. Because you have been programmed, this is why you do that. And what we want is let it go. We want you to let it go. Release. And allow yourself to receive. But why you can't receive, why the flow doesn't come to you, it is because you have blockages inside you. Many type of different blockages that doesn't allow you to receive. You receive, but it's like you have opened a rabbit hole, not a full door to receive. This is a very important thing to understand. To get more abundance, more money, you must open yourself fully and release all the blockages that prevent you to allow yourself to receive fully. Let's take an example, very simple. We send you water through a pipe. Everyone knows what it is. It's very easy to visualize a big pipe with water in it. But if they have dirt in it, dirt that crystallized, because that dirt is there for so long, how do you want the water to pass through the pipe? It's impossible. It is the same for the energy of abundance, the energy of money, the energy of love. You have dirt inside your system. Imagine that you have different pipes in your system. And we send you the abundance because the world is abundant. The abundance is there. The abundance is existing already. You just have to tap in. You just have to allow yourself to receive it. But because they have dirt inside your pipe, some pipe can be blocked, then you can't receive. And you try through another pipe to open another pipe. Imagine you have millions of pipes through your system, and we send you this abundance. And the universe is sending you, everyone is giving you the abundance, but you can't take it. Or you just take 1%. Because it's blocked pictures that in your mind. And let's do an exercise together. Close your eyes and just now ask yourself, where do I have dirt that blocked the canal? Says, I give you the example of pipe to make you really understand the big pictures. But you all have canal portals on different dimensions, and all of you have many blockages. What we want you now is asking yourself, asking your body, and asking your higher self, show me. Where are the blockages? Those blockages that doesn't allow me to receive abundance, to let the flow of money coming to me. Where do I have those blockages? And when you are able to locate those blockages, it can appear to you as a dark dot, stone for some of you, mud. Everyone is different. But you will feel, see. Some will have both, but it's not very important now. The most important part is that you have located that blockage, that dirt that blocked your pipe. And now place your finger on it. Physically, place your finger and ask what this energy, this blockage is representing. Show me. And images will start to come to you, or sensational voice. It can be anything. It can be grudge, can be hurt from the past, can be a person that you could not let go of it. Can be someone you have lost, someone who died, and you cannot let go of that story. Can be many different things. Because it's a group setting, we will not enter in detail here, but just recognize what it is. Don't judge it. Just feel it. Feel it. Identify from where it's coming from. Maybe it was not yours. Maybe it is something you have absorbed from your parents as a child. Maybe it is something that is present since past life. Maybe it is a luggage from your ancestral lineage that you have accepted to help your lineage. Can be anything, but for now, just identify it, allow it, and just visualize it clearly. Find from where it's coming from, since when it's with you, and what does it want from you? Ask this energy, because this blockage, this doubt, is an energy originally that has been crystallized, yes, but it's an energy. And now ask, what do you want from me? How can I help you? Because if it's there, it's because you allow it. It's because somehow it was giving you maybe a comfort at that time. Can be any reason, good or bad. Don't judge. Sometimes we do things that make no sense when you discover, but it had sense at that time. Don't judge yourself. Just take the dirt with your finger. Imagine that you take it up nicely. Don't hate it. Don't repress any feeling. Just embrace the situation now. Acknowledge that energy that blocks, that is within you, that maybe you wanted to have for a specific learning. There have always a reason for why we have blockages, why we cannot let go. There have always a reason. But we don't want to hear the reason now. We want you gently nurturing and say, what do you want from me? What can I do for you? Because I want you to go out of my system and I want you to be free. Then let me know, what do you want? And see what this energy will make you feel, what this energy will tell you of what it wants from me. Can be forgiveness, can be a new learning, can be anything, but embrace it. Don't judge it. Don't repress it. Don't reject it. Accept it. Everyone makes mistakes, but it's important to understand that you can correct everything. Everything is possible. Can be a long work, but you can do it. Because you have a lot of dirt, as we said, but you can address it one by one. Now, gently take the dirt outside. And maybe that dirt is asking to go back to where it belongs. If it belongs to somewhere and someone else, maybe it has to be buried. Maybe it has to be burned. See what this energy will tell you. Or maybe you just have to be transmuted into the light. And then I want you to go to the place where you have been removed that dirt and infuse light in it. Imagine that you open your crown chakra and that all the light is coming from above your head, entering through your crown chakra, passing through your head, and go directly into the place where you have removed this blockage. And we'll go now to fill in that place. Fill in fully and completely. And let this energy entering into each and every cells of your body. It's like giving food to your cells. Healing maybe cells that has been damaged because of that blockage. Just feed your cells with that remainder. And if you want, direct this light everywhere in your body, in your throat, in your spine, in your heart, in your shoulders, in your arms, in your hands, in your stomach, liver, pancreas, spleen, intestine, sexual organs, all the bones, legs, knees, calf area, feet. And then imagine this light is going into the hood and give it also to the hood. And visualize some roots under your feet to ground yourself, plant your roots into the hood and send light to the hood. Thank you for your question. Khadija, do you have another question?
Yes. Wendy, how can we effectively overcome addiction?
Okay. How can we effectively overcome addiction? Adama wants to answer to that question. Okay. Every addiction, no matter what it is, the most well-known are alcohol and drugs, but they have addiction to work, they have addiction to sex. Always, it's coming from a lack of. And that lack is mainly love. Know that when a being, we speak here about human being, is not complete and whole, every place where they have a lack of, needs to be. Addiction starts with a coping mechanism. Most of you will say, I'm bugging, he's speaking too fast. Sorry. I received the message telepathically and then I have to pass it in English. And I'm bugging, sorry. Every addiction starts with a trauma. That's what many of you will say, but not always. Sometimes it's a coping mechanism because you run away from something. We have seen people becoming addicted to alcohol simply because alcohol was a distraction from a boring life. You are not traumatized, but you are bored. And many people fall into that trap because it's enjoyable. And when you are not complete, when you have a lack of, no matter where it is, you will easily fall into addiction. Now, how to overcome addiction is by feeding yourself with love. Letting go of the addiction is not always working for some people. It will work for a certain percentage, but not for everyone. And you ask, what is the answer for that? We want to tell you that is love. That seems big. We heard you. But only love can heal. Only love can heal. If love was much more present on your planet, you would not have this. Now, to overcome the addiction, do not focus on the addiction itself. Do not focus on that. Focus on the love. Heal every part of yourself. Because like we said, it's a lack of. Find the hole. Where are the empty places inside you? Find it. When did it start? When we say that, it means everything starts into the past, not yesterday. And something in the past made you losing a part of yourself or giving a part of yourself or not loving yourself. You have to find and identify those empty places. Find out when this is happening, at which moment in your life. Why did you give a part of yourself? Many of you sacrifice themselves to help others and forget they exist, just to feel they exist, they're valuable. I'm helping, then I'm existing, I'm important. This starts from a lack of. Then to heal your addiction, don't forget, don't focus on the addiction itself. Focus on bringing back the love to yourself and filling those empty space. Thank you for your question.